Thank you, Madam Ambassador. Jean Kirkpatrick in a reply to the Reverend Jesse Jackson. Election time seems to bring out opinions and comments and analyses from a wide variety of sources, some of them highly unlikely, a few of them almost entirely unexplainable. Here's one of the latter, Dr. Ruth Westheimer.
Telling you I don't know anything about politics. All I know about is sex. Actually, I don't know much about sex either, but I know what I like. You know, I've been watching this election year very carefully, and I have reached a conclusion, or as we say in my profession, a climax. The 1984 presidential race is exactly like the act of sex. You see, the campaign is the foreplay. Months and months of foreplay. And then on election day, we have the orgasm. And if we are watching the news on television, sometimes we have the orgasm in advance. I'm sorry to say that from what I've seen and heard, many registered voters this year will be faking the orgasm. And why not? For months and months, the candidates have been faking the foreplay. Whatever your feelings are, you must go to the polls and vote. And when you're alone in that voting booth, it's all right to fantasize. This is good. Think of something erotic, anything. Imagine President and Mrs. Reagan in bed. Try to forget that together, they're nearly 140 years old. But when you pull the lever, pull it with passion. Good night, good voting, and good sex.
On this last weekend before the election, as you might expect, all the polls are in, and there's one not seen before. It's called the Newman poll. I polled myself. Here are the results. I found that I am 38% undecided, 22% uncommitted, and the rest of me said, Ed, take your poll and get out of here.